Hello everyone, welcome to the pubcast. My name's Ottimo, and this was a cast request by one of the users on Reddit. I think it's an in-house game, but I'm not quite sure. I know that it was a captain mode draft, but since I suck at drafting, I really didn't think I should give my opinion on the drafting stage. But let's look at the two sides. On the radiant side, we have Lina being played by Liti. We have Beastmaster being played by Juki-chan. Kawaii, I guess. Dragon Knight being played by Jolly Okinen. The hell is this Japanese thing we have going on? Han Solo, being played by Undying King of the Born Tombstone. Lastly, we have Onalua on the Sven. We're gonna have to go back to Undying to discuss in a bit. On the dire side, we have Tuskar, being played by See For Yourself, Hydro on Juggernaut. Not sure what this guy's name, how he spelled Keratan. Kuril on Nyx Assassin, and lastly, who's left? Someone's left, yeah. We have on the Phoenix Ubermaster. So it looks like the Dire will get the bomb rune and the Radiant will get the top. They give it to the Dragon Knight and the Nyx Assassin. So looks like it's going to be a support Lina, as quite a lot of tangos and Observer Wards. I'm not sure if this is going to be a Tranquil Boots. Not sure it's the best boots for her. They already saw this one, it looks like an immediate D-Wars coming out. Sorry. Allergies in the morning, I'm not sure what. And there you go, very nice move by the Phoenix, just immediately dewarded. He could have actually he could have eaten the ward, I guess, but as I save it for the tango. Full life anyway, doesn't make a difference. And we have the Undying. Undying, I'm really not comfortable with him taking Tombstone level 1 because you can't spam it. It dies in 3 hits, not that good. You want to take Decay to help you harass, so I really don't think that you should ever take Tombstone level 1. Sven looks like he's going to be the farming carry here. And then on the bottom, sorry, the mid lane, we have Dragon Knight versus Nyx. And Nyx doesn't have any mangoes, which is something that we see a lot of Nyxes go for. Yeah, this should be okay. I definitely think the Dragon Knight has the advantage. His ability is more spammable, though he doesn't have as much mana. He should have, once he gets his ball, I don't really see him losing the lane. Plus, you know, Nyx Assassin. He can't really be harassed though, he has so much HP regen, it's very difficult to harass this hero out. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, so we have the wards coming out here, this blocks it. And it's going to be solo Beastmaster here. Both teams seem to not wanted to go tri-lane, aggressive tri-lane, and both teams seem to have dodged each other. Beastmaster probably could farm a little bit with his wild axes, but it's going to be really difficult. He's up against too slow. Oh dear, that was risky, and looks like he should be okay. Stun this command, can he be spun to death? I don't think so. He should be alright. Yeah, he's very tanky. And they didn't have the Venomancer. So yeah, both lanes pretty hot, pretty aggressive. This lane has a stun, the shards, the slow. He can get Frozen Sigil, and of course Spin is going to do a lot of damage. Top lane, we also have a couple of stuns and Tombstone. I do think Phoenix shouldn't die. If someone's going to die, I think it's going to be more likely to be the Beastmaster, simply because Phoenix has his dive. And also Phoenix, he's ranged, so it should be a bit hard to get him. Then again, Beastmaster will never go in melee range because you have wild access. Inner Beast, I don't really think there's anything for you taking it early on. At least in this lane, because you're not going to be auto-attacking anything. Oh, there we go now. No. You guys called the wild. I would have preferred if he went more points in wild axes, makes last thing a bit easier. So, yeah, I don't think you need to take any points in inner beasts. You just want to take the call of the wild and wild axes for now to help you last hit. Maybe you could last hit with the boar once or twice and use the bird to scout. Well, Lina looks like she's taking a bit of harass. Both teams playing pretty cautiously right now, and I think both things coming out relatively even, I'd imagine, right? Yeah, 100 experience is nothing. 100 gold, like what's this? What, 70 gold advantage. Both teams just coming off really well and very careful. Honestly, this is not a pub game. I think. I mean, doesn't seem like it's a pub game. Oh dear, Beastmaster gets killed. Oh, what the hell? I just sit there, careful. All right, looks like Juggernaut is just gonna try and dive in. Takes way too much harass from the tower. And for Beastmaster, I can't really say he did much, he just ran away and there you go. Oh, he might be able to go for that. He may have gone a bit too far. One hit will get him and they can't. There you go, he's dead. Nice ice charge, but He got first blood, that is insane. Beastmaster getting first blood? Totally wins the lane for him, basically. Because they, remember, he's up against three people, so if he can get a kill, that's huge. And he's even sending the Tuskar to go back to the fountain. Phoenix needs to be careful. Has a point in Sunray, don't see that very often. He should be able to get his Tranquil Boost very soon, and at that point he should be pretty safe. Oh, nice stun coming out from the Lina. Is he gonna stun out? Oh, well, Sven, that was weird. Should try to throw out the stun first. Sven should throw his stun first, I think, and then Lina follows up. Again, the Tombstone really not gonna help them here. I feel like Undying should maybe go bottom or something. He would be so much help bottom lane. Okay, Axe has come out. Misses. The second Axe misses on the Venomancer. But I don't really think Undying does anything top lane. And there we go, he is coming bottom. Nice. I predicted it. See what a great caster I am? Sort of. Kinda. But yeah, now you can see the Beastmaster is a bit more aggressive than he used to be. And with Wild Axes and the Boar, along with Tombstone, they could be able to get quite a few good kills here. They're up against three, but it should be okay. They're on middle lane. Even CS so far, 15 and 15. Both of them, I think, have both of them have bottle, and you don't see this matchup very often. Dragon Knight against Nyx mid lane. Dragon Knight rarely played, to be honest. And Nyx doesn't very rarely goes mid at all. We're going for 3-1-1 basically. That's how you want to go for it. And yeah, Dragon Knight also pretty much maxing out breath of fire. Was it breath fire? Yeah, breath fire. Undying is here. I would like if he had 1 point in every skill. If he had Solar, that would be very useful for you. But level 2 or 2 is also pretty good in a lane like this. And looks like there might be a gank in the mid lane. They smoked up. Dragon Knight is going for the bottom ruin. They'll probably see him with this ward once he gets there. And yeah, there you go. He walks into ward vision, gets it. Now they're going to go for him. Can they get it? Seems nah, he didn't go the way they wanted him to go. Looks like he's gonna gank bottom, and now Juggernaut's just gonna run back. Okay, now Dragonite's here. Can they get a kill on him? It's not really very likely. The what's it called, the Gale? What's it called? Damn it! His first build misses, and can they get it? It's looking like it's unlikely. What about Beastmaster? Can he get the kill? He needs to hit him once, and yeah, oh, turning around caused him to die basically, and he just Dragon Knight just walks right past them. Nice stun coming out, but a bit stacking. Looks like Juggernaut is gonna fall, but we'll be able to kill the Lina first. He does kill the Lina first, and now it's Nyx Assassin. Nyx Assassin, can he throw a stun or anything? No, looks like he's just gonna be able to run away. Look at those zombies. That zombie, I don't know who is chasing, but it's really going after someone. And in the end of the game, at the end of the day, they lost the Lina, they killed what, the Venomancer and the Juggernaut, so it's a 2-for-1 trade, I believe, favoring the Radiant, but they'd have to rotate quite a lot to get that. Juggernaut going for 2 points Blade Dance. I don't know if you really want that. I feel like Blade Spear is, you know, it's a lot better now than it used to be. Lower cooldown, more damage. You kind of want to max it out if you're going to go for it. Either you get 1 point or you go full. You can't go 2 points. It's like, it's not worth it. You might as well have gone 1-1-3, or you go 3-1-1. You can't go 2-1-2. It's just, it's not worth it. Okay, my shard is coming out. I'm dying. Oh, he really doesn't want to go soul rip for some reason. I don't think that's a good idea. So experience now in Dire's favor, gold and radiant, because they have slightly more kills and they got first blood. Lena has an invis ruin. Is she gonna go with it anywhere? This bottom lane. There's 4 people from the Dire here, and there's 2 people from the Radiant. You know there's gonna be a dive. Okay, Juggernaut going in, and Undying doesn't have enough mana to use his decay. They take out the Tombstone first, and Beastmaster doesn't have enough mana to cast any of his spells. Looks like they're just gonna send them back. Sven is teleporting in. Dragon Knight actually caught up out of position. Nice stun coming out, but dodges a bit with the Ox. What's it called against Snowball? And looks like, oh, they do kill the Dragon Knight. I thought he might be safe. 5 people from the Dire here, and everyone also from the Radiant. Looks like Lina's coming here. She has Envy, but does not have her Lagoon Blade. Level 4 stun comes out, hits on 2, very nice. But can she actually kill anyone? This healing mode is healing them up very nicely. Should probably micro it a bit more. There you go. And two kills for the Dire side. But again, this is a big brawl. Everyone's here from both Radiant and Dire side. So this was a big investment for the Radiant and they lost. They should have just kept people in their own lanes. Of course, it's hindsight. It's very easy. It's very easy after you lose a fight to say, oh, we should have done that. But it's like, yeah, that would have been way better than for them. If they had won the fight, then of course it would have been worth it. So decisions in Dota sometimes are really dictated just by the result. Honestly though, I would have thought that someone should have kept farming. Probably the Sven should have rotated, because I don't think he really got anything out of it. I do think the Dragon Knight, it's a hard decision, it's very hard to say. And in the game you see a gank, you see four people in one lane, you're like, I have to go help out my team. Alright, it's almost 10 minutes, let's look at some of what heroes are going for. Ring of Bastos on the Lina and no boots. I don't know if she really needs Ring of Bastos. Looks like we might have a kill here on the Juggernaut. Nice stand coming out. Can he? Looks like he's probably dead, yeah. Nice job. Beastmaster doesn't really have much items. He's 3-1-1, but he doesn't really have much in terms of items. What's he gonna buy? His second net worth. Does he have anything on the courier? Oh, okay, there you go. There you go, that's a lot. Looks like he has the wand and power treasure. Dragon Knight, what's he got? Bottle, not much in terms of item progression. Falling Blade, interesting. And Dagnus is gonna go rush Arcane Boots, that's gonna be helpful for his team. Then Venomancer just gets blown up very fast, nice stun. Not sure why he dropped the Tombstone. I feel like Undying perhaps could be playing a bit better. I don't know. I don't know why he dropped on the Tombstone just now. That was very unnecessary. It looks like Sven gets dropped. How did that happen? So he went in close. Snowball comes up. Nyx here. And Phoenix uses his ultimate. Not sure he needed to do that, but gets them the kill anyway. It's a good kill for them. Sven, how's he doing? He's actually the pack in net worth. Looks like he has power trism. Not much else. He also isn't putting up a point in great cleave. You see a lot of people doing that nowadays, so I don't really think it's worth taking a point in great cleave early on. He has more points in one point in stats, which I think is more useful. On bottom lane, Trigger not actually takes quite a lot of damage. I like that. Okay, now he's going for more points in Blade Fury. He could have had it maxed out. I don't know why he's going. Even though the mana cost also gets lower per level, so I don't know, a bit confusing for me. Arcane Blitz now out on the Undying and help keep everyone's mana up. You could, yeah, give her some mana. Oh man, screw Lina, she doesn't need mana. Duskar has his bottle. What's he gonna go for? I see some people put 1 point in Frozen Sigil going 3-1-1. I think that's kind of cool. But also, you can go for more points in the Snowball, just as good. Let's say Phoenix has his Tranquil Boots, has his Urn. Looks like he's gonna go for Mech next, maxing out the Fire Spirit. That's pretty much what everyone maxes out these days. They do see the Dragon Knight. Dire Ward's pretty good. And can they get the kill on him? Ooh, Dragon Knight's in. I don't see him making out this alive. He's dead. Nyx comes out, gives him that Vendetta hit. What about Venomancer? Ooh, he has the Orb of Venom. Orb of Venom does stack with your passive. And this guy's going to go for more points than Venomancer Gale. I don't think you want to take points in Plague Wards if you're not going to max it out early. Because it's 75 life, so. And it gives like 20 gold, so one hit and then he gets 20 gold. You really don't want to spam it out. I would have preferred if he had went more points in Poison Sting or he maxes out Plague Wards. You can't. 1 point Plague Wards is really useless and it's only good for defending. And I don't think they're getting pushed in any lane to make it worth it. Dying level 6. What is Nyx Assassin then? Nyx Assassin might be going for Dagon. And he's going for Max Spite Carapace, as they call it. I don't really think you want to go this. I feel like Mana Burn is better to max out. On the other hand, they're not many mana heavy heroes. I mean, they are kind of mana heavy. Okay, looks like Venomancer again get killed here. Oh dear, look at that. Axis coming out, gets the kill. Very nice. Yeah, I feel like Mana Burn is the better one to max out. Maybe, of course, maybe he's just gonna put 2 points. Oh no, he's getting 3 points. Yeah, he's gonna max it out. The cooldown reduction is nice, I suppose. Oh, top lane, missed the kill. Looks like Mana just fell pretty fast to the Juggernaut Omnislash. Yeah, I think the Nyx Assassin is going to go Dagon. Dagon pretty good this game against the Lina and I guess also the Undying. You want to burst them out down pretty fast. Everyone else pretty tanky, not the easiest to burst down, but hey, extra damage is extra damage, regardless of whether it can insta-kill someone or not, it's extra damage. Looks like smoke's coming out. Dire Vision is pretty good. They have a ward here, they have a ward here. Radiant not warding as much, I feel like. They only have one ward here, which is also good, of course, just it's only one ward. Okay, looks like we have a skirmish here at the top lane, and Beastmaster's here. Lina's following. Looks like they're just gonna run back. Oh dear. Meanwhile, we have the tombstone coming out. Nice stun coming out, but it's only on one person. Can he bottle himself up? Nice ice shards, keep him alive, but it's not enough and he still falls. Four people here now on the radiant side. Look at that zombie running so fast. I guess the next. Oh, stun does come out. Nice stun. I think it actually stunned the range creep and. Wait, that was really cool. I think he stunned the range creep and not the. Yeah, see this? He aimed at the range creep and hit the mix because he was in range. That was such a good play. Holy crap. That was beautiful. Mix was a bit too far, but he was still the AoE of the stun. That was very nice. Honestly, that was a huge play. Really good stuff. I don't think they would have gotten the kill without it. Oh, Roar comes out and they killed the Venomancer. Looks like he was just caught by Roar and just killed. Laguna, we still haven't seen a Laguna Blade, but they seem to have not need to use it so far. That was such a good play, honestly, the way the Juggernaut, sorry, the Sven played it. Very nice, very nice. Sven looks like he's gonna go for either Helm of Dominator. No, that's not like, no, he's going for Armor. He's gonna jump in, gonna kill the Lina. Wall Sponge bit excessive if you ask me. And yep, the Misa's gonna make that alive. I don't think they need to use Wall Sponge to be honest. Looks like shards can come out. Shards. There you go. He sees him. Shards him in. And if only he had Walrus Punch. Ooh, stun almost misses, but does land in the end. And there you go. Kill coming out. Sven's here. Nice stun on two people. And Tombstone looks like he's just going to make that alive. Couple of zombies after them, but it's no big deal. Ice shards to block the way. And there you go. Whew, interesting. Now 18 kills so far. And looking at the net worth, we can see the Juggernaut is really quite far ahead of everyone else. And he's gonna go for the Mask of Madness build. He likes the right click. And we can see that Nyx is number 2 Nyx. May not be going Dagon, he could afford it. I think he might be going Blink Dagger if he's not going Dagon. But both are fine. Well, I figured he would go Dagon because he had a null talisman. A little surprise here. Yeah, it's the region ruin. Doesn't quite need it. Looks like Venomancer is gonna be in trouble. Does he have the man? This guy has been roared so many times. Stun does come out. I think they have stacked a little, and they do kill the Nyx. The much more important kill than the Venomancer. But all right, looks like we might have a kill here. And I see ice shards the Lina, and can they get a kill Lina? It's a two, maybe two kills instead of one. But here's Juggernaut. Sorry, here's Ben. Gets one. Needs one more hit. And no, they can't kill the Tuskard. The zombies chasing me everywhere. They do kill the Lina in the end, and Tuskard? Good day. No, he survives. Nice ward here as well. Dire warding is exceptional. They have also ward very deep in the enemy forest. Tusk has arcane boots. I can't say I like this because it makes him be more of a support later on. I feel like you want to go phase boots or maybe even power trades, but going arcane boots. Especially when you have already arcane boost on the Nyx, and I think someone else is building arcane boost, was it? But no, Venomancer has nothing. Holy crap, that is one poor Venom. But then again, Venomancer, what does he do besides using Poison Nova? Yeah, so Plague Wars level 1. It's absolute garbage, basically. And surprisingly, he didn't go for the Morbid Mask, but instead goes for Vlad. It's gonna help his whole team out, gives him all a bit of armor, some lifesteal. But besides him, is there any really right-click hero besides that Juggernaut? Tuskar sometimes right-clicks, but I don't think he's a right-click hero. And Nyx Assassin, yeah, he uses his Vendetta and he uses a couple of Autex, but he's mainly a magic user. Alright, Nyx is gonna go for a Dragonite, can they get the kill on him? Walrus Punch comes out and spun to death. Magic damage, pretty good on Dragonite, who has a ton of armor. He probably does more damage using Blade Fury than he does on Omni Slash, because actually not Omni Slash, level 2, but if it was level 1, he would have done more damage using just Blade Fury. Alright, someone's coming in. Nyx Assassin comes in with a Spike to Carpacci and able to reflect. Very nice. He does have his Envy ready if he needs it. And Sven is here. Sven, Still doesn't have his armor, but getting close. Nice location for the tombstone. And oh my god, Venomance, that was totally not worth it. Looks like they're gonna be able to kill the Beastmaster in return. Egg comes out. Maybe a bit too far for forward for the Undying, so it's a 2-for-1 trade for now. Looks like they're gonna go. No, they're not gonna go for more. The Venomancer walking in there was very wishful. I'm not sure who's doing. Now they're gonna trade, and looks like they're gonna get the tower. So they trade towers evenly, but two kills for the Dyers. No, sorry, 2-for-1. So favors the Dire side, and we can see that the experience is also favoring the Dire side. 5k, gold also 3k. It doesn't look like they have much of an advantage if you look at kills and things like that, but their farming is so different. The carry Juggernaut's doing so much, has so much more gold than Dragon Knight or Sven. Sven has 4k, and Juggernaut's almost double of that. So it doesn't feel like they're ahead, but they are, and they're ahead by quite a bit, actually. One of the things I think about is that warding on the Dire side has been so good. The Radiant have no wards on the map right now. And they have... they don't even have wards on any of their heroes. Or maybe they do have on the lane, but for now, let's look at this. Dragon Knight. Dragon Knight, really no chance he's going to make it out alive, surrounded by pretty much five heroes. Lina has one ward, but how much are there in the shop? Yeah, you have two wards here. And just... yeah, their supporting staff on the Radiant side, it's, I have to say, slightly weaker. Venomancer, sure, he's feeding a little. He's 2 out of 5, but he is warding. That's something that's huge for them. Alright, nice stun coming out by this Sven. It's two people, and good long looking for the tombstone as well. They might be able to get a kill. Nice spinny coming out, and they kill this Sven. They kill the Dragon Knight. Tombstone gonna fall one more hit. There you go. They lost the Tuskar. Nice decay on 2. Doesn't use his ultimate though for some reason. Looks like Undying wants to go for the mech for his team, and that's fine, but his farm is pretty bad. Whereas they already have the mech on things. That's one other huge difference. The sustain is very different on both teams. On the Dire side, you have the mech, you have the healing ward, and you also have the sun ray, which doesn't give you much HP, but it does give you HP and an urn, which is very big. On the Radiant side, you don't have any sustain. They have, you know, arcane boost, but that's not life. So, and they don't even have soul rip. So without mech, without any healing abilities, they are easier to be bursted down, and we're seeing that a lot. Undying, I really don't like that he doesn't have any poison soul rip. I don't think that you want to max out soul rip before decay, unless you're going for very fast aghanim, in which case decay is better. But yeah, I feel like his build is not helping his team. The max tombstone of course is great, but and he did use his ultimate in the last fight, which was kind of weird, because why did he have it? And Dire just gonna take this tower. Alright, we might have a jump in. Sven doesn't have his armlet. Oh, jump in by the Nyx, but doesn't look like he's gonna get any kill. Nice ultimate by the Venomancer. They do burst down the Juggernaut. Ultimate coming out from the Phoenix. Very nice location, really hitting everybody. And Dragonite, they're able to clean out, so the Venomancer's fall. And looks like it's, okay, Sven's gonna fall. And so is, it's a 3-for-2 right now. Can they get anyone? This tombstone has done so much work for them. It's a 3-for-3 right now. They have to clean up all these damn zombies. Nice axes coming out. Oh, stun misses by about a mile. And looks like Lina's gonna pay for her insult. It's a 4-for-3, but still, that was a huge fight for both sides. Gold favors the Radiant, experience favors the Dire, but I'd say it's relatively even. The only big problem is that, of course, they lost the tower. So you give the edge slightly to the Dire side, because they did take a tower after all. Again, Venomancer, more wards, love it, love it. He's dying, but he's getting wards, like what more could you ask for? He's not playing himself as any sort of core role, he knows what his job is. Also, one of the things I didn't like was the early Ring of Vassals. Oh, she's maxing out, okay, let's. You don't need max Fire Souls, you want to go max Light Strike, right? The damage increases and the stun increases. There's very little reason to go max Fire Souls. I really don't think that this Lina should be doing that. It does not help her team. So, yeah, I don't really think you should ever go max Fire Souls. What does max Fire Souls gives you? A bit more attack speed and a bit more movement speed. The movement speed is, what, 2% extra? And you're not going to be attacking that much anyway. Sure, she does do good damage. No one's going to argue that. But if you can get a Lightstrike Array on a couple of heroes, is going to do so much more damage, and the stun duration is going to be so much better. Top four on the net worth are Dire side. That's a bit difficult to see in bottom lane. Sven, he's gonna fall. Turn on the armlet. He didn't turn on the armlet in time. He could have turned it on, maybe get a stun off, but he was dead to rights. Beastmaster, one point in the beast. I like his going for max blink dagger. You generally want to go max. Max blink dagger. What the hell? Blink dagger, and generally want to go for maybe Aghanim's afterwards. And looks like he's gonna be caught out. This is gonna be very difficult. Maybe a tombstone. Yeah, there you go. Ultimate comes out. He is used by the undying, but see, they're all just back to full life, and now they're just gonna go clean up the tombstone. They get a tower. They get two kills. It's a bad thing to see, really. There you go, tombstone. That's 150 gold, I believe. Yeah, 150 gold. Now they're going on the undying as well. Need to retreat fast enough, and undying is gonna fall. Oh damn, this is brutal. They're going one by one. Now Lina's gonna fall. This game has really spiraled out of control, it seems like. They got a tower, they got four kills. Sven died very early. And it was just one kill after another. In the meantime, at least the Dragon Knight is split pushing, which is what he can do. He realizes he can't help him, but he's not really split pushing fast enough to make up for five heroes. And they're gonna go, they got the holy crap. Jump in. No, it looks like he smashed me. Got stun coming out, but again, they have this healing ward keeping everybody full life. It's level 2, so 3% HP per second. And they get the Melerax. Dragon Knight? Where is he? Dragon Knight looks like he's just teleported back. Now they get the ranged rank as well. Again, didn't think it would go that badly for them. Now they're gonna fight, but it's really not worth it. You should just let them go back and spin. It's going to fall. No armlet use again. And looks like Rogue comes out, but isn't able to get anyone. Tombstone, they threw this tombstone, but looks like it was a bit far. Juggernaut also kills the Dragon Knight. It's a 2 for nothing so far. Looks like Undying is gonna fall. If only he had some sort of healing ability. Lina comes out, but she's gonna die as well. Wow, this is brutal. I didn't think that the game would spiral so fast out of control for the Radiant side. They're gonna have to really dig deep to get this back, because it's a 10k experience. Like I said, it was 5k, it was manageable, then just slumped down. Gold is, again, just 4k, then just went to hell in like 5 minutes. Duskar now has a blink dagger. Duskar, he also has the drums, gonna max out Frozen Sigil, so they could take Roshan if they want. Deso out on the Juggernaut, so he's gonna be able to hit really hard. Bit of an odd item build, I'll be honest with you. You don't really see. Oh wait, well, what the hell? He has Aquila and Vlad's? I don't think you want that. You want one or the other. Interesting. Yeah, I don't. Yeah, you know, not sure why he. Why sell it? I also. He only has. He has Deso coming. He has space for one more item. I'm not sure why he sold it. Anyway, that's on the way. I'll discuss items more, but I can't because Tombstone comes out, nice. A Breath of Fire coming out. Can they get a kill? They're gonna go for the Juggernaut here. In the meanwhile, in the backline, they do kill the next assassin. They can't kill the Juggernaut. Yeah, he doesn't have his armor slash though. Nice Phoenix Sun keeping them. It's a 2-for-1 right now, favoring the Radiant side. Like, okay, now it's a 2-for-2. It's an even fight, but still, if the Radiant can make it out of this alive, it's gonna be good for them. Juggernaut throws out, Sven throws out his stun, gets Wallace punched to the face. Ah dear, oh, you kill him with the Laguna Blade followed by Dragon Slave. And now Beastmaster has bought back, he needs to do something with his buyback. He throws his axes, and that seems to be it. Undying finally has a mech, so that's gonna help his team up. But that was a very bad buyback by the Beastmaster. He just came out, he threw his axes, and that's it. It's really not worth it. You can't really afford to throw your gold away like that. Nice ice shard just to kill the birds. Looks like they're gonna get the tower as well. Another not terrible exchange for the Radiant, the bad. Not one that puts them forward. Alright, this is gonna be interesting. Aghanim's on Nyx's assassin. Oh, this is the burrow ability. You get it, go to the ground, you get 1.5 HP and mana regen, you get 40% damage reduction, your stuns are gonna be very long as well as your mana burn. This is gonna be interesting. I'm curious to see how it looks. Beastmaster might be building into a Necronomicon. That's gonna be helpful. What about Dragon Knight? He's had the Shadow Blade for a while. Now he goes for Cloak. gonna help him tank up. He has a ton of physical resistance, so some magic resistance is gonna give him some survivability that he desperately needs. Undying has his mech. Gonna go for our Guardian Greaves. Guardian Greaves is very good against damage over time, because once your HP is below 20, you get extra health regen that helps keep your life up. So very good against the Venomancer. And Sven looks like he's gonna go for BKB next. He doesn't seem to be using his armlet so much. Maybe I'm just not catching him, but so far when he dies, he seems to die. At least in the last seconds of his life, his armor seems to be always being turned off. I don't know. So many good wards on the dash. And holy crap, one here, one here, one here. Their wards are so good. And I think they may have spotted that smoke. I'm not sure. They might spot it now. There you go, spotted now. And looks like the Phoenix is going to make it out alive. Let's take the stun at the end. And we'll be able to kill him out. They do kill the Venomancer. Venomancer is probably the weakest person on the dash side. Lina falls, and looks like they're going to lose the Beastmaster as well. Sun comes out, and can they kill the Nyx? Nyx is pretty damn tanky, and they're going to kill Sven. Sven is going to... he does fall, but it's okay. General actually buys back. Not sure if that's really worth it. The Undying, he's going to fall as well. Can they do anything here? They have the Sigil, and looks like Dragon Knight's going to be okay. He has the Shadow Blade, should make up. It's a 4-4-3, the Juggernaut bought back, so that's something they could get out of it. See the fight recap. Yeah, they get much more gold, because remember the Juggernaut buyback. Experience, relatively even. Dragon Knight, yeah, he's gonna go for BKB too. BKB is the name of the game, for now. This guy hasn't made anything for a while, but he does have 2.8k gold. I do wish he didn't go Arcane Blast. I feel like it hasn't been too useful for him. So the Courier Blink Dagger coming out for the Phoenix, gonna help him land those the Suns a bit more. He can just blink in, use the Shiva's Guard, I guess, if he wants to. It's gonna be very nice. Not a very common item, I'd say, on the Phoenix, though. Nyx Assassin hasn't made much progress. Might be considering going for the Dagon now? I don't know. I feel like going early Aggies, not sure how useful that is, but we'll see. Juggernaut. What's gonna be? Ogre Club. Is it going to be a BKB? Yeah, I think BKB. He would have component booster if it's going to be Aghanim, so yeah, BKB. Venomancer, holy sh! I mean, wow. He has his Aghanims already? I'm surprised. I didn't think he was farming that well. I was like, oh, he's 6k, you know, maybe he'd go for, you know, arcane boots into 4 staff or something. But you know, he went for Aghanims, that's nice. That's a ton of damage. The damage increase from Aghanims is insane. I mean, from 55 to 85 damage, that's a lot. That's 3 extra per level. Alright, looks like Dire coming to knock down on this middle. They have the Aegis on the Juggernaut. This is going to be a very hard thing for them to stop. And shockingly, the Phoenix is number 1 net worth. He does have a gem. I think the gem is only going to help them against the Dragon Knight, so that's okay. And if he drops it, though, it's going to be risky, because they have... They lose their Nyx Assassin. A lot of his abilities would be kind of nullified. Well, we'll get engagements here now. Let's go up into this high... I'm not sure what you call it. High resolution? It's not high resolution, but... Let's zoom out, basically. Everyone's here. It's going to be a big rumble. Can the Radiant hold this? They do have one BKB. They're on the way on the second BKB. I don't know if they can hold this or not. They're having trouble with the plague wards, it seems like. And this ward is gonna expire soon. It gives them a lot of vision that they kinda that helps out a lot, but you can also put up plague wards. Slowly the mid tower is taking a tiny bit of damage over time. Not the best, but we'll see. Does anyone have she does have a sentry or she should put it here. But it's expired anyway. There you go. She sees it at the last second and gets the gold at least. Wow, that is a long stun. Holy shit, that's incredible with the Aghanims. And looks like they're gonna dive in. It blinks out, but still gets hit by the stun. And Sven is here, again not using his armor, see? And looks like they're gonna kill the Tuskar. Nice ultimate by the Venomancer, gonna keep a lot of their lives alive low, but it's a 2-for-1. Juggernaut going in, he might fall, but he does have the Aegis, so it's not a big deal. Again, Sven not using his armor. Now he uses it, which is way... And he turns it off immediately. And looks like they trade 2-for-2. Definitely favoring the Radiant side, because of course they're the ones behind. They're trying to do a bit of damage here. Juggernaut gonna go in, but remember Aegis, so he doesn't really care if he dies or not. Sven's here, throws out his stun, hits on 2 people. And can he get anything? Again, no omelet usage, no omelet usage. They do get rid of the Aegis, so technically a 3-for-1. Juggernaut still has his. No, he already used his army slash, he knows. And now that you can do some damage on the tier 4s, fight recap shows that it is definitely favoring the Radiant side. And they're just gonna back out of there. Alright, this time I. Okay, fight's still going. And Sven's here again, no use of the armlet. Oh, now he uses it. You should use it before the fight starts. Stun misses, but actually hits the Dragon Knight instead. Blink out by the Nyx. Can they get. Oh, nice Yules. Very nice Yules, but not enough to land the stun, and he's just gonna teleport. They have nothing that goes to the BKB. Looks like Phoenix is gonna make it out. Wait, someone is here though. Nyx Assassin is here. And he just managed to make it out safely. Ward. Now, Radiant Ward's coming out here, but it's not gonna be. They're not really gonna hang out here much, I think. Ooh, jump in by the Tuskar. That ward saved them, but it's immediately the ward. The gem, too good. Sven, here's the thing. He's not using his items, so I feel like active items are really not that great for him. I mean, I don't think that when a fight starts, he barely uses the armlet. So I don't think he's gonna use the armlet and the mask mask and the BKB. Don't know about you guys, but I feel like that's not gonna happen. And I think armlet is good, but he shouldn't even go on Blink Dagger. Blink Dagger is a harder item to forget about. Armlet, you're like, oh, you know, you forget to use it, but Blink Dagger is a bit harder to ignore. Overall though, he bought armlet, he hasn't really used it to its full effectiveness, and I feel like that's related to why they're losing. Alright, looks like we have engagement here. Beastmaster. Caught a bit out, but looks like here's the one winning. They might be able to kill the Nyx. Actually burrows in, but now he's gonna fall. Huge ultimate by Venom Lance. Pretty much hits everyone. And along with the Phoenix Star, it's a wombo combo. And there's a wombo combo that's pretty much gonna destroy the Radiant side. Holy crap, Undying's still alive? How the hell is he doing that with all that HP regen? And looks like they're gonna kill. It's a 2-for-2. Did they kill the Dragon Knight? Did they have the gem? The gem is on the Phoenix still. And one more hit. And he's gonna make that alive. How the hell did Undying make it out there? He was. Not lethal damage, I forgot. He has so much HP. Is he going for Vanguard now? That's a bit late. Good trade for the. Well, even trade, I guess. And then actually buys back. But they're still gonna be pushing in. And might be able to destroy this tower very soon. A couple more hits. Alright, looks like Tombstone comes out. Juggernaut in a bit of trouble. He put in the Tombstone, but he already takes the Laguna Blade. And Self Yule's keeping her alive. Can they get the kill? Who are they going to go for? Juggernaut's a bit hard to bring down, but. And he does have a BKB, so he has a ton of magic immunity. Looks like Dire Side really want this tower, but they're going to have to back out for now. Man, the Radiant side have been stuck in their base for the last like 10 minutes or so. That's really, yeah, it's kept them a pretty low net worth. But as the game goes on, 15k net worth, 15k gold defense becomes not as big of a deal. I'm not gonna say it's not a big deal, it's a huge deal, but, you know, if you're 15k behind at 28 minutes and you're 15k behind at 37 minutes, you could say that you're actually kind of stable. You're stably bad, but stable. Experience also that's gonna change again, same thing. So they're behind, but they're consistently behind, which is somehow sounds like an insult, but it's not. It's like, you know, the difference in their differences remains the same, but as both teams get stronger, it becomes less of a difference. So they're holding. It's very hard to explain what I'm trying to say. One thing they do need is they need more vision. They are so starved for vision right now. Oh dear, Nyx Assassin jumps in. Not sure he should have done that. Takes a lot of Carpacci things are returned. And Phoenix Sun's here. Can they get the kill though? No one's attacking it. And no, Phoenix comes back. Nice ultimate by Venomancer. It's level 2 with Aghanim's. This guy has been landing his ultimate so well. This thing's gonna fall. And so does the Phoenix. Shocking, actually. The gem is now on the floor. It's a 2-for-1. And oh dear, Nyx Assassin, they do spot him. Can they kill him though? And this is just gonna be safe now. Nyx Assassin needs. Oh, nice Carpacci. And oh my god, they all hit him right now. And he's able to teleport out there. That Carapace was so good. Can they kill the Juggernaut? Sven? I think he turned off the armor and died. Is that what happened? I'm not sure. Not the best armor toggle I've ever seen. Undying, maybe you could. No, he can't. He couldn't use his Guardian Griefs. Can they kill him? Do they have the gem? No, they have sentries. Dust. Oh, no need actually. I said he might be able to. They might kill the Nyx. Nyx is gonna blink. He does blink. Back to safety. Oh dear. Long fight. And Radiant favored, honestly. They do also get the gem, which is huge. Who carried the gem? Dying, I got the gem. So that's 900 gold swing for them. 1800 total, basically. I got the gem and the enemy dropped it, so good for them. I still feel like they're kind of really behind, and Dire, if they wanted to, they could just, you know, take over their forest. They have enough good wards that they can see what the Radiant are doing, and Roshan's up, so Dire should consider taking Roshan. When you have map control, what you should do is just get more map control. So when they have all these and the enemies stuck in their base, which they're smoking up, which is the smart thing to do. They're smoking up, they're trying to get a pick off, because the enemy might be split up trying to farm, so if they can get one or two kills, that helps them free up their map so much. It's still a bit of a long shot though. The smoke comes out here, can they go anywhere? Looks like the Dire's are getting ready for Roshan. Next assassin's building a Lincoln's, I think. Okay, they see the Beastmaster. And this is one of the things about Plague Wars, you're not gonna be able to teleport for... Oh, wait, you can? Wow, okay, this is something new. I thought poisonous thing stopped. Weird. Didn't know that. Oh well. Yeah, it looks like Jerem's gonna do a very nice placement of the healing one. He puts it on the high ground, so it becomes very hard for the rain if they jump in to destroy it. This is really something that you don't see every day. This is really good. It may look small, but it's a huge, makes a huge change. The same as putting a tombstone on the high ground. Very nice play, honestly. Experience only 10k for the Dire. Gold 15k. Yeah. Tusk is here. May not want to do this in Aegis now on the Juggernaut. 40-minute Vanguard. What do I think of it? I think it's really bad. I think that he should have gotten Lads for his team. If you go on Lads, he gives everyone armor. Oh, if you get... And it's cheaper, I think. Getting Vanguard just helps him, and doesn't... And I'll be honest, it's not going to help him that much. He should have gotten Vladimir's for his whole team. 5 extra armor, lifesteal for both the Dragonite and the Swim. I don't like this item choice at all. I'm not sure what he's building either. Oh, he's going to go build for the Crimson. They're going to jump on the Juggernaut. The last person will jump in because he does have the Aegis. He's going to come back to life. Can they kill the Phoenix Egg? No, they're not going to focus. They are focusing on... Can they kill just one more? They do kill it in time. Very nice. And they're going to go. They're focusing on the Juggernaut. Sorry, the Tusker. Tusker falls. Juggernaut does use his ultimate. And no armlet use. Nor the Morbid Mask. Sorry, the Mask of Madness. Now he uses the armlet. You have a Mask of Madness? You have a Mask of Madness? Finally. So four. Holy shit, those are four for five. And again, I'll go back to this. He is not using his Mask of Madness or his armlet. That makes them completely worthless items and a waste of gold. But holy shit! 4 for 5? Is the fight recap coming up anytime soon, or did I miss it? Wow. And Ragnar going for stealth quest. They need this mass armor thing. And they need a pipe as well. That's what they need. And yep, huge fight for the Radiant side. Huge. And the people who got the gold are the people who need it. Sven and Dragon Knight. They need to go for Vlad and they need to go for Pipe, because they need to get some sort of as much resistance and survivability as they can. The BKBs are good, but they need to get something to go up against the Venomancer's Poison Nova, which is also going to be much harder now that they have a Veiled Discord, so you definitely need to get Pipe. I don't think Crimson Guard is going to be as helpful as a Vlad's, and it's way more expensive. It's nice to have it, but I feel his gold would have been way better spent on a Pipe. It's been 42 minutes, I'd like to look at some of the items, honestly. Ring of Basilisk is up, not much item progress on the Lina, she's 3 and 14, she's died quite a lot. Beastmaster hasn't been able to make his Necronomicon either, so that's another problem they're going to have. Dragon Knight, can he buy the Assault QS? I think he should have, he has a lot of gold, he should be able to afford it very soon. Undying, Crimson Guard, and the Guardian Greaves. The problem with this build is that it's nice, but if you had Agonyms, you'd scale way better with DK. And Pipe is honestly better than Crimson Guard at this stage. It's just better. Sven doesn't have his crit. I like this because it's not an active item. I know maybe I'm being a bit harsh on him, but he is not using his items, and that's something that could help him out a long fights. Imagine if he was using Morbid Mask of Madness just now. Or like jumping on the Beastmaster. When they had them all trapped, if he had his Mask of Madness on, he could have gone 3 or 4 more attacks in. Completely changes the entire fight. So one of the reasons that they are not winning is directly due to his item usage. And oh, it looks like they're jumping in on the Venomaster. Can they get the kill? Venomaster? Oh nice, put in the snowball. Beautiful play by the Tuskar. And now he's gonna just use his ultimate. Beautiful. Throws out the Veil as well. Very nice item usage. And he does fall. Looks like they're gonna get the Tuskar as well. Now it's time for the Juggernaut. Phoenix Egg comes out in time. And Juggernaut goes... dies! Oh my god, I can't talk. Looks like the Phoenix should make it out alive. He doesn't use the Phoenix far enough. And Lina ends up dying to the poison, or maybe to the creeps. Wait, let's see that what happened. Anyway, let's see this. Where's Lina? She's only hit by the poison. Oh, she's gonna die. Oh, come on. That is not that. Oh dear. He was hit by the poison, no, so he wasn't gonna die. He had one life, and the creep just didn't kill him. That is. Oh, come on. That was an unnecessary death. Tuska has his BKB. Again, I don't really like that he has a BKB. I mean, I like that he has a BKB, but again, I feel like if he didn't have this Arcane Boots choice, kind of screwed him up, made him go for more defensive. Not defensive, but more utility items. Juggernaut. Tanky has a Cream Bash, but he's been falling pretty fast in these last few fights. I'm not sure why. I don't know if he even uses Omni Slash because he hasn't been dead that long. Phoenix has the Hex. And that's going to be helping him out a lot. Another thing is that I don't know how useful the Blink Dagger really was. You do have the Icarus Dive. And Master, I really was impressed that he was able to use Veil and his Poison Nova in the last fight before he died. That was very... he kept his cool. And Nyx Assassin, still trying to get that Lincolns. Number one on the net worth is the Dragonite. And you can see that now that the Dire don't have as many wards in the enemy forest. That gives them a bit of map control. Necro 1 comes out on the Tusk. That's a bit surprising. So what are they going to do now? They don't have the Roshan advantage. And they've been consistently losing fights to the point that it's almost back to even for the Radiant side. I mean, at this point, 8k gold is a very minor advantage, I'd say. Daedalus is up on this one. Another, I like this. I really wish he had gone through. Again, not to flame him, I mean, the guy threw out a really good stun in the mid lane, I remember when he did it, but his item usage is his biggest weakness. So, you know, could improve a little on that. Okay, this master's here. We'll jump in, okay, jumping on the Juggernaut, and looks like they're just gonna... no, Warsaw Punch doesn't come up. Okay, Sven is here. Again, no item usage, but whatever. And looks like Dragon... will they be able to kill the egg? They're not gonna focus... can they focus the egg? No, they're not. I don't think they're gonna destroy it in time. And they don't. The Beastmaster falls and buys back. Looks like Lina's also gonna fall in a second or two. She does fall, and it's pretty much a massacre. Everyone's buying back on the Radiant side. But it's not gonna be enough. They killed two people, actually. I'm not sure they should have bought back, because I don't think they die are gonna push in without their Juggernaut. Pushing in with just Phoenix, Venomancer, and Nyx is not... I don't think they need to do the buyback, and that's gonna cost them. So look at how much gold they lost from that. They are actually pushing in. Again, I'm a little surprised. I don't think they're pushing with just these guys. It's a 3-on-3, and I think that the Radiant may have the advantage here. Oh wait, at this point, Network is really useless. Buyback is what matters. And they have a buyback on Undying. That's about it on their side. Yeah, I don't know if they should have fought back. It's a hard decision. Lincoln is up on the Nyx Assassin. I think the Lincoln is going to be for his friend and not for him. If he puts the Lincoln on the Juggernaut, the only thing that goes to BKB is the what's called Primal Roar. So if he puts the Lincoln on anyone who's a bit low life, then they can be hit by Primal Roar. And even Laguna Blade if they don't have BKB. Of course, it's not an Agnum's Laguna Blade, so it's not as scary. It's only 850 damage, pure magic. Roshan, pretty close, roughly, what was this, 40 seconds left? Yeah, those buybacks cost them, cast them aloft. Unfortunate for them. Experience also gonna go back down because they lost that fight. DD Ruin here. Who's... I guess they want the Juggernaut to take it and they'll try to push. Good wards coming out. They still have the gem, I believe, on the Radiant, do they? Do they have the gem? Holy cow, did they lose the gem? They did lose the gem. Who has it now? Oh, yeah, Venomancer, okay. This is really unfortunate for the Radiant Titans. Like, Attack on Titans, they're stuck behind their walls and they can't go up. But every time the Dire have come, they haven't been able to actually get them ever since they took down the bottom racks. They have caused some damage, though. They, look at, there's no more tier 4s. Slight, well, not really much damage. There was a tower there at one point, but they took it quite a while ago. Wait, do they have any smoke? Smoke may help them out. Where is it? Yeah, they do have 130 seconds. It is still risky, though. The Dire Side aren't gonna be farming. They want to end this game. Really not comfortable with the Screaming Guard. What is it block? 55 damage, I think, to block? How much do you block? 55, yeah. I mean, when the enemy is hitting you with, what is this, 350, 360 damage, you kind of feel like 55 isn't really that much. Yeah, they're just going to be on the Juggernaut. Could have put a Frozen Sigil, but I don't think they really need it, actually, when you think about it. He could probably take Roshan all by himself. Smoke is up on the Lina. Will they use it, is the question. Will they be able to get anything out of it? We do get... Cheese is available as well. Who's going to take it? Anyone? Maybe drop the teleport scroll, I think. There you go. This guy is stacked as all hell. I think he should probably get Guardian Reeves next. Yeah. It's an extra slot. Okay, they're smoked up. And maybe this might not be the time to go for it, because they know that they have the Aegis. And they need to not focus on Juggernaut. It's really hard to decide what to do. If you kill Juggernaut, he's going to come back. If you don't kill Juggernaut, he's pretty much going to kill you. Jump in. The war comes out. Oh, blocked by the Lincoln Spear. Holy crap. And Beastmaster is probably gone to the fight. And Sven uses BKB, but he's not close enough. Again, no use of items so far. He's able to get one kill on the Tuskar. Now, who are they going to focus for? They try to focus on the egg. They not enough. Oh my god, one hit. Lina's gonna die. Looks like Dragon is gonna fall as well. The only person who's made out alive is the Undying, who didn't use his Crimson Guard. What the? Oh my god, why did you buy Crimson Guard and not use it? Holy shit. Well, without buybacks on their team, the only one who has buybacks is the guy who survived. Tragic irony if you think about it. And looks like that's gonna be game. Very good hold by the Radiant. They held it for like 20 minutes, and there you go. Time to use that buyback, I guess. But I think the Radiant's biggest problem was their item usage, honestly. Undying bought items he shouldn't have. Same thing with this Ven, who didn't use his items. It was a good game, honestly, but I feel like Radiant could have... There's a bit of a gap between in skill, I feel like, between Radiant and Dire. Dire just kind of way better. Well, that was my cast. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to the channel if you do. Keeps me motivated. Thank you for watching.